All right, guys, welcome back to the DrewCast episode 56. We're gonna just get right into it, man. So, it's Black History Month, dog, and it's not starting off good, in my opinion. We're gonna get into a little sports talk here, guys, but Brian Flores, he was just the coach of the Miami Dolphins, and his team had a winning record. They literally started out 0-7, and then he ends up winning, like, what, the next so-and-so games. It was crazy. He is suing the NFL. And he is suing the NFL because he believes they misused the Rooney Rule, which when we've talked about this off camera, Dustin, and by the way, guys, with me tonight is my disembodied voice, Justin. I get why it's in play. I get why they have it. But the simple fact that you even have to do that, I feel like is super fucking embarrassing. You know what I mean? I'm not black, by the way, obviously. You know what I mean? But like, I would assume, right, that black people would find that insulting. Like
that's what I was going to say, is I get why they have it, but it just feels like an insult.
Like, I'm only getting an interview because I'm black. Like, you already have the coach you want in mind, probably, but I'm only here so you meet your quota. That would be so insulting to me, bro. Like, you know what I mean? And black people and, like, people of color in general, they deserve more than just a, oh, I'm just here to meet your quota. That's why the Rooney Rule to me is trash. It's like fighting racism with racism. Like, you're only getting an interview based on the color of your skin.
They do that at like, you know, like XXL. Yeah. How they have like the ciphers and stuff. Mm-hmm. They like have to add it. And they don't have to, I guess, but they like, they add a girl, like, no matter what. Like, you don't want me here because I can rap. You just want to
meet a quota.
Show everybody that you're diverse.
A lot of these things, like with companies and what you just mentioned, a lot of these things are, it is racism fighting racism. Oh, hey, we're going to fight racism and sexism with what you just said. Like, it's not because you can rap. We just need a girl on the thing, on the cipher. You know what I mean? So he's suing the NFL for that. Text messages between him and Bill Belichick, he leaked. I'm pretty sure he leaked them. Yeah, and Bill basically, like, oh, you already got the job. But he didn't know he was talking to that Brian Flores. He was talking to the new coach to the Giants, who was from the Bills. So, like, basically, Bill already heard that guy was given the job, and Brian Flores hadn't even interviewed for the Giants head coach position yet.
He was going to.
Yeah, he was going to, like, right, like, the next day or two.
Some shit like that, yeah.
So they already picked their coach, and Brian deserves more respect than that. He had a winning team. So we're going to give a coach with the winning record. That's what we give you? Like, I don't like that, but it didn't sit well with me. It didn't sit well with me when I heard that story. But yeah, the Rooney Rule, if you guys don't know about it, what we basically said in the beginning, like, teams are obligated to give you an interview in the NFL just because they have to have
a minority coach interview.
And the fact that they even have to have that rule in place is trash in the first place. And, you know, so we off camera, we talked, and I I don't know if you agree with me on this, Justin, but I do not feel like there's a solution to the Rooney Rule. I don't think there's a solution to it. What can we do to solve this problem? We can't get rid of the Rooney Rule because then the owners are going to go back to never fucking hiring black people, right? Because that was why the rule was invented. But if we continue with this rule, then I'm only getting an interview because of the color of my skin. It's not because I'm an actual good coach. It's not because I have experience, right? You remember when they gave the guy from the Giants, what's his name? I'm forgetting his name, man, but it was a recent coach for them. We'll put it up here if, you know, once I find out his name. He had no coaching experience. They're trying to give Josh McCown a fucking coaching job with the Houston Texans. He literally has no coaching experience. Yeah, so we're not going to put up the name because I had Justin look it up. It's Ben McAdoo. Yeah, this guy, no really, like, real coaching experience. And they hired him. Josh McCown, again, has never been a coach in the NFL. The Houston Texans are talking about hiring him. Right? So is there a way to solve this? I don't think so, man. I don't know what you could do, technically. What is that? Do you have an idea? Like, what do we do? Like, you can't solve that problem.
No, because I think just if you're racist, you're racist.
Yeah, and I mean, like,
which happens to be, like, I guess a fuck ton of the NFL.
you can't just come out and say it either. Like, hey, we're kind of racist here, bro.
Which Brandon talked about it earlier. Like, the NFL is ran by like a bunch of like 70, 80-year-old white dudes. Like, they're fucking racist, bro. Like, you making a rule isn't gonna make them not racist.
Yeah, they're just gonna.
They're just trying to look not racist to the public.
Brandon also had a good, which, by the way, if you're watching or listening, Brandon's a friend of mine from high school, still a good friend of mine. He was saying to us earlier that if you notice, a lot of rebuilding teams will hire a black coach. Let them shit the bed, fire them, and then hire a different, you know what I mean? You start to put the pieces together, like, that does happen a lot. You know? Oh, they will hire a black coach when they're in the rebuild mode. And they're just like, yeah, trying to get tank for Trevor, you know, like, I don't know, bro. And then the talk about tanking, this guy said that the Dolphins owner was bribing him to tank. A lot of people might not think this, but that's a huge story, man. And we thought teams were tanking, but they're literally being bribed to tank. You're ruining the integrity of the game when people start saying like football's faked and rigged. Whoa. You know, look, they're bribing coaches to lose games. Didn't he say Hugh Jackson came out today and said that the Browns bribed him to lose games too?
Yeah.
That's crazy, dude. Think about working your entire life for this. I'm in the NFL, either as a player or coach, right? I'm in the NFL. I worked my entire life, sweat, tears, college, all that. And then the owner's like, hey, just tank. I'll pay you for each loss. Like, what? I don't know, man. That's bad, dude. Imagine, like, you know, we sit here every week and we talk to people and we try to entertain and we try to create our own business, right? But what if they found out it was fake? Like, oh, I don't actually care about this. It's just, let's just tank. Like, no, I don't know, man. I don't like that, bro. That just doesn't sit well.
I don't think it's fake, but they're definitely not trying to win.
Do you think they tell the players that?
No, that's what I was just about to say is I think when it comes to like the most fucked up thing is the players, because the players probably obviously want to win. They just don't know that their coach is like purposely putting them in positions to lose.
Like, hey, why are we running on third and...
Yeah.
Like the Seahawks.
Like, hey, dude, like it's third and 12. Why are you running? And the coach is like, you know, he holds the leverage, so...
Yeah, So, like I mentioned earlier in the episode, it is Black History Month. Reason I'm bringing this up is because it is happening during this month, which, you know, kudos to you, Brian Flores, because they might do you like they did Kaepernick, man. Which, the Kaepernick thing, I don't want to get into because I don't fully agree with Kaepernick, bro. This guy, didn't he have a documentary? Remind me, where was his documentary released on recently? Was it Netflix?
I didn't even know he had one, to be honest with you.
And he was like trying to like compare like the NFL to like the players to slaves and stuff like that. Like, I didn't fully agree with that, but like his message still stood that like, hey, I feel like Brian is going to be made to be the coach version of that. Like, he probably won't get a head coaching job. I don't see it happening. Like, you know, they're not going to, you know, people who speak out against this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
You know what you like.
Well, he said that. He said that he knew that was on the line. He just wanted to, I don't know what he said word for word, but I think like the gist of it was he was trying to like break the cycle of, you know, not standing up for his people. Some shit like that. I'll try to put it up because he did say something along that line.
The point is, I mentioned a couple episodes ago how I was trying to be like the William Wallace of podcasting, right? Like, I'm willing to give up everything. I'm willing to give up what I love for certain people to hear certain things. You know, if he ends up losing his career over this, that sucks, man. And like, speaking of someone who should have lost their career, Whoopi Goldberg. Now, I don't... So The View is kind of funny because, like, it really just... It's, like, so... I feel like the tone is... The View, sorry. I feel like The View is very tone-deaf. We have, like, the liberal, the conservative. We have... You know what I mean? Like, it's not that we don't want to hear women talk, but we don't want to hear those women talk. It's, like, it's cringy. So now... You put them all together and they just start talking about like Trump and you know what I mean? Like, have you ever seen a clip of the View?
I think I've seen clips of like a female panel of like women like talking on a talk show type thing, but I don't know if it was The View or some other show.
It's almost like a parody. Like it's a parody. Like you just have a bunch of like these old heads like getting together at a table and like
I get what you're talking about though.
They're super uneducated.
Like nobody wanted to see a fucking talk show with like Whoopi Goldberg. Like what does she say about
and,
what?
And she's like, you know, so she gets in trouble for anti-Semitic remarks that she made, or people view it as that, and someone's like, what did she say that was wrong? You know, like everything. So they suspend her. She should have got fired. She should have got fired. Gina Carano got fired from Star Wars for less. But because Whoopi is like a left-leaning, like, liberal lady, she gets saved. The suspension. Oh, you said this? It's okay. We suspend you. You know, like, no, dude. This month was weird. Like, so we got Brian Flores, like, taking a stand against the NFL. Then we got Whoopi. Whoopsie.
Uzi trying to bleach his skin?
Is he? I didn't know that.
It's just that's not off to a hot start.
That's not looking good. Uzi trying to bleach his skin. Didn't know that. Is there somebody that's trying to make their skin darker? Like, why do we never see that? We always see people bleaching their skin, but like, bro, why don't we ever see someone like trying to like reverse bleach their skin? I know there's that Rachel Dorzel girl. What's her name? The girl who pretended to be black and she's transracial or whatever. Which, you know, I mean, I wish that was like not a joke, but she really did fucking say that she was transracial. It's fucking funny. But yeah, so Rooney Rule, trash. I don't like it. I don't see a way to fix it though, which sucks. There's not really a way to fix the Rooney Rule, so we're just gonna have to see. And with Whoopi, man, like, ooh, like, first of all, whoever made The View, like, you don't deserve like a career. I don't know. Like, at family gatherings, when all the women get together and start talking, that's the last fucking room I want to be in. That's literally, like, the last room I want to be a part of. So, you made that into a TV show. When all the aunts and grandmas and moms get together and start, you know, like, bah, 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 bah. Yeah, that's the last room I'm trying to be a part of. And but they said, you know what we should do? We should make that a TV show. We should make that a TV show. People actually watch The View. Have you ever heard a person in real life say they watch The View?
No.
Now, it's not, to me, it's not really about the woman factor of this part, because, like, yeah, I would watch women talk on TV if they were cool and not Whoopi Goldberg and the fucking Ozzy Osbourne's wife. Ozzy's wife's on there? What are you doing on there, bro?
I think that's the point you're trying to get across.
It's like, what? Ozzy's wife's like, I don't know, and Trump is bad. I don't know. Remember when her daughter was like, remember when her daughter was like, well, Trump, if you get rid of Mexican people, who's going to clean your toilet? She thought she ate too, and everybody was like looking at her like, hello, like, you know
did
what I mean?
Did she really say
yeah.
that?
Yeah. Yeah, she goes, oh, Trump, I got a question for you. If you get rid of Mexicans, who's going to clean your toilet? Everybody was like sitting there staring at her like, she thought she gay, bro. She was like waiting for everybody to applaud, and like everybody was like, "How like boo? What? No, Mexicans just don't clean toilets." It's like really tone deaf, bro.
Yeah, it's funny as fuck.
Orange man bad. I don't know. Trump bad. Orange bad. Liberal. Wear a mask. We must wear two masks. Bro, they're just like, they literally just regurgitate what the fuck they hear. I guarantee you, bro. You think they go home and like make their own note? They have their own notes?
No.
No, people make those notes for them. Hey, on today's episode, Whoopi, guess what? Whoopi, come here. Maybe.
You're telling maybe. Me, I, like, I don't so think some executive at The View told Whoopi to say the whole Jewish Holocaust shit that she said. So she went off script then.
She went off script.
It sounds like it.
She said, I can't read the teleprompter from here. Fuck it. I'm just gonna fuck it.
You know what I think about Jews?
Yeah.
Whoopi, no.
You know what I think about Jews? They were like this. No. She's like, no, don't cut me. Don't cut. Don't stop the footage. I got something to say. Jew making me crazy. But yeah, no. off the Rooney Rule shit, but on to football. My guy Tom Brady retired. And you know what I mean? Like, it's one of those moments that hit me. And it's like, I was sitting on the shitter. Like, I'm not even joking, bro. Like, Josh hella fucking scared me too. Because Josh messaged me and he's like, hey, so it's not fake. And I was like, I was sitting there for like 10 minutes. Like, what does he mean by that? With no context, this guy's just like, so I guess it's not fake then, huh? I was like, what does he mean, bro? Like, I was kind of like hella paranoid. Like, you know, like I didn't do anything wrong, but I was like thinking in my head, like what I did wrong. Then I go to the bathroom and I read on Twitter that he retired. Then reading that, it just completely, like, you're in the moment. That's one of those moments that you'll never forget. You're like, Tom Brady's retiring. Damn, man. Like, he actually said he's retiring now. And you read it and you're like, fuck. He played in the NFL for 22 years. That's literally 22 years of my life. I got to see this guy play football at the highest level. Winning Super Bowls, losing Super Bowls, trying to get a perfect record. I think the first Super Bowl I ever watched, I believe, is when the Patriots played the Panthers. And the whole Janet Jackson boob thing happened. Which, by the way, my friend's mom was hella funny for that, because she tried to pretend like we didn't just see a fucking tit. Oh, we saw a tit, bitch. I wanted to say that, so you know what I mean? Like back in the day, like, she was like trying to, oh, there's nothing. Like, no, that was a boob. And a pretty nice boob, may I say, Miss Jackson. Sorry, Miss Jackson. But that boob was fucking nice. But that's the first Super Bowl I ever saw that I can remember. And where I'm actually, like, taking in the football knowledge. Pause. And it was a really great experience for me. And then going forward, you know, like, Tom Brady was at the highest level, the best competitor, man. So it sucks seeing him retire, because it's like, that's like a part of my life that's gone now. You know, people probably felt like that when MJ retired. You know, when he stopped playing basketball, people were like, damn, MJ's gone. Just sucks that, you know, and I'm pretty sure Brady could have played for a couple more years too. And it's crazy because we never got to see him be bad. You know, we saw Brett Favre be bad, right? We've seen, like, the greats be bad. But they're the greats, you know, like Emmett Smith went and played for the Cardinals, and it's like, this doesn't look good. You know, like, Peyton Manning was fucking throwing ducks. It was weird seeing Peyton Manning throw ducks. Like, he'd throw it and the balls was like ducking.
Yeah, Peyton Manning was pretty bad, but people kind of forget about that because he won a Super Bowl and then just dipped. So he did kind of go out on top, but he not skill wise. No,
I mean, it was bad. It was hard watching him at some, like, when it was hard watching Peyton Manning at towards the end, because it's like, damn.
I feel like that was Drew Brees as well. Drew Brees, his last like year, maybe two, was
it's hard to watch, bro.
Noodle arm.
He would like try to cock back to throw like a 40-yard pass, and that shit was like wobbly and like. But yeah, I'm glad we didn't get to see Tom Brady go through that. We never got to see a bad Tom. Like, to me, who gets to say that? They went 22 years in their profession. Probably got injured maybe once or twice, really. Like, Tom was never... Like, he missed a full year. I think it was the year after the perfect season, where they tried to go for the perfect season. But besides that, like, he would get injured, but, like, it wasn't really, like, major. Like, Tom had a really good career. So it was cool. He, you know, he deserves a statue, is what I'm trying to say. Anybody in that gets a statue right now, it's Tom Brady. And where would you put the statue, though? Is it going in Boston, or is it going in... obviously, it's going to go in Boston, but...
Yeah, might as well, right?
You know, let Bill... Bill's just here, and then, you know, I'm just... Brady's going to get a statue, you know what I mean? And just saying, can you imagine if he... We need to see that. Like, the Hall of Fame speech. Tom, you were great. Bye. He just walks out the thing. But yeah, speaking of people with statues, So, last week, I had a Kobe segment where I was talking about Kobe and Gigi. It was the anniversary of Kobe Bryant's death. And I wanted to talk about, you know, just that situation and people's, like, when celebrities die, people get all this, like, oh, you know, when Betty White died and everybody, like, there was people on my Facebook, like, you know, oh my God, how am I going to be able to breathe now? Just breathe. I mean, just UBI. Breathe. You'll be all right. Betty White didn't know you. So, I mean, you know, sorry. She's everybody's grandma, but like, you know what I mean? Like, but I cut it. I cut that segment. Because you know what? Literally, while Justin was editing that podcast, I see that they built a statue for Kobe and Gigi at the crash site where the helicopter crashed. And I said, Justin, we're cutting that Kobe segment and we're moving it to this week. It's really fucking pathetic, bro, if you think about it. It is like super fucking pathetic that I don't know if people agree with that statue being there, but not only does Kobe not look good on the statue, they put him in his jersey, which I've had problems with that in the past. What, you know, those podcasts I used to do with, like, it'd be like Kobe in heaven with wings and like he's in his jersey, and then RB, you know, the Supreme Court judge who died, she's in her gown and gavel. And like Alex Trebek is running a fucking Jeopardy heaven game. You know,
like all in the same
Chadwick
picture.
Boseman's in his fucking Black Panther outfit, and like, and Michael Jackson has the glove, and you know, I don't like that shit. To me is so goddamn cringy. So we put the, not only do they put the statue at Kobe's crash site, right? Well, these were not just Kobe and his daughter died, other people died there, right? We put the statue there, tone deaf. Then they put Kobe in his game jersey. You know, I don't know. I think the statue being at the crash site is super fucking tone deaf, bro. Like, that is super fucking cringy. Out of all the places we could put this statue of Kobe and Gigi, the crash site?
I don't know where they died exactly, but like, it wasn't in like the mountains or some shit. Like, who's even gonna see that?
It was like hills, the hills of Calabasas, right? It was in Calabasas, wasn't it?
Was it like accessible mountains though? I thought they just kind of crashed like not in the middle of nowhere like that, but like I thought they just crashed in like a mountain.
It was like a hill mountain area, yeah. Like, but it is accessible though.
Oh, okay, I didn't know that.
I don't know how accessible it is, but you know. We had that controversy earlier this year, or I think it was like last year, where Vanessa Bryant was suing the LAPD because they were...
She's still in the process of doing that.
Okay, but they had pictures of Kobe and they were like sending them to people and showing people. And so I already don't fuck with that situation. Like, you guys already were like taking pictures, you know what I mean? Like, hey, guess what, bro? Look at this picture of Kobe.
Yeah, they have a guy, they have him on camera doing it too.
That's so cringy, man. And then on top of that now, because I already don't fuck with that situation, they put a statue of Kobe and his daughter at the crash site. I don't fuck with that, bro. Sorry, I don't care. If people could be like, oh, it's to remember him. Yeah, then, you know, bro, we can remember him in a different way. We can. We can. Don't try to justify why it's at the crash site. And if people defend that, it's the little, Justin, it's the fucking little cocksucker dweeble people that are like, oh, you know, celebrity, like, bro, celebrities do not know you. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't fucking care, right? Most of these people, they make millions and billions off us. I talked to you about that before. They make hella money off us, bro. They don't give a fuck what we think. You know, the Kobe Bryant's death was one of the only times I was actually sad about a celebrity dying. And it was on some human shit. Not because he's a celebrity, but it was on some like, whoa, bro, what?
That, like, he had a family, kids, like that type of stuff.
Yeah, and I'm like, that actually was like, whoa, bro, what the fuck? Like, that was insane. You read the story and like, bro, what? Like, it kind of made death permanent. Like, bro, I know everybody dies, right? And that's not a question. Everybody does die. But like, when Kobe died, someone at that level of success and fame and that level, like, bro, it's like, whoa, you know, like, no matter how rich and famous you are, bro, death's coming for you. Your time will come. And that was the first time I was like, whoa, bro. But like, any other time a celebrity dies, yeah, I'm like upset. But like, all these people, like, so weirdly, like, we have like a weird celebrity like obsessed culture. It's like people, I don't know. It's just like, oh, you're sticking up for someone you don't even know, bro. You know what I mean? Like, you don't know them. But you will share when Rihanna gets pregnant, people will share that article. But when their friend opens up a business, nothing. That's the problem, man. Like, the celebrities don't care about you guys. They make millions off you. They get to fucking do whatever they want, basically. The laws don't apply to them. They make millions off us. We're the ones that are the reason they're famous and rich. But they treat us like we're like ants. A lot of celebrities do, bro. And if people get on here and start like, but, yeah, you're just adding to my point. You think that fucking this celebrity is going to hear you defend them? Most of the time, they don't give a shit, dude. You know, sorry, but like, so back to the statue thing. It was cringy as fuck seeing that, dude. I don't like it. Not cool. You don't get brownie points for putting Kobe in his jersey. Nope. None of that, dude. And if I ever die, don't fucking put me at the crash site statue.
I'm not like a statue expert or nothing of the sorts, but like that statue looked like ass, dude.
To be honest,
most statues like kind of do. Like, I don't know. They just kind of change the way they make statues, man.
You're an expert in my opinion now. You looked at it. Just fucking ass. You should be grading statues, bro. I get a job for that, you know? What about this one, Mr. Ortiz? You're like, it's not lit.
Oh my God. You remember the Ronaldo statue?
Oh, that was horrible.
Yeah, we could post that too. That's just kind of what I think of when I see shitty statues. That always goes back to that.
It's kind of pause-worthy to make a statue of somebody too. Kind of. You made a statue about another grown man. You went out of your way to replicate this person. Like, unless that person's Jesus, bro, why did you make a statue of them? Tom Brady deserves one. Yep. Jesus. Mm-hmm.
There's a kid that I went to school with who died when I was in middle school, and I don't know why. I do know why, but they made a statue in like his neighborhood, mm-hmm. like recently. The reason why I say I don't know why is because he died like, I don't know, 15, 16, 17 years ago, maybe. No, it's like 16. But like, that's why I said I don't know why they made it, because it's been so long, but it got a lot of hate comments for how bad it looked, because it didn't look like him whatsoever. And like the artist and the mother, they were saying like, oh, you don't know how hard it is to make a statue, and you don't know how like the work it takes. And they're right, I don't, so I don't have any right to be speaking on that. But like, if it doesn't, like, in my opinion, that didn't look like Kobe at all. The statue of the kid didn't look like the kid at all. Statue of Ronaldo didn't look like Ronaldo at all. Like, if it looks like that, why even make it?
Yeah, I think it's because people are too fucking busy trying to cancel Joe Rogan that they don't give a fuck about certain, like, you know, oh, when it comes to the important things, we're just going to overgloss that. But yeah, I don't agree with the Kobe statue. Shit's ass. And no one's ever going to change my mind about that, so. But yeah, before we end tonight's episode, guys, I'm bringing back Meme of the Week, like I told you guys last week. And right here, this is the meme. Right here, there's a bunch of, and these aliens are definitely appropriating my culture. So, canceled. Is that a sombrero? And tequila? Yeah, canceled. Right? Isn't that what we're fucking about around here? So, but the meme goes, so they know how to make energy from the sun, but they're killing each other over oil, and they wonder why we don't contact them. Like, how fucking true is that, dude? To be honest with you, we talk about a lot of deep stuff on this podcast, and that kind of can be deep or funny, depending on how you look at it. But it's almost comical now. Like, I would imagine being a higher, like, alien, like a bean. Not a bean. I'm a Boston bean. No, but, like, I can imagine having, like, a way bigger consciousness than we have now, and just viewing Earth, like, as a comedy. We're probably a comedy show. We're probably some aliens comedy show. Like, we talked about how here's the solution. We just shrug. Like, bro, imagine how other, like, aliens view us. They're like, hey, they literally could have free energy right now, but we're still doing oil. Oh, hey, why? Like, and honestly, too, like, how are aliens supposed to, like, come here and, like, want to, like, visit Earth and, like, show us things when there's people who can't handle when a black person breathes? We have the Rooney Rule. You know? So, but an alien's gonna come from another planet and visit us. And you don't think those people are gonna be, you know what I mean? They're already starting it. Demons. Aliens are demons. They're already starting the dehumanizing of aliens. So you imagine they come here, like, hey, we're trying to show, God, you know, like, we're trying to show you guys cool things, and then we're demons now? We're probably a comedy show to somebody, dude. Honest to God, I wouldn't be surprised at this point if this was all just a reality show. To be honest with you. Like, aliens probably... This is probably why they don't visit the general population if they do come here. Which I believe they do. But if they do come here, they're not talking to people like us. People like you and me. They're not talking to those type of people. And you know who else they're not talking to? The people who are... They can't decide whether they want... a black person to stand next to them. But hey, I'm an alien from another planet. How are they going to, like, how do you think racist people would handle that, son? How are they going to handle...
Exactly, probably how you think they would.
How are they going to handle a person from another planet, let alone they can't even get along with people of color on their own planet? Like, we're killing our own planet. We're destroying this planet. And we expect to be able to go to another planet. Like, we want to figure out space travel. Should you, or should you stay and fix Earth? I bet aliens do so much cool shit and they look at us like, hey, we don't do the whole solution. I bet they don't do that. Like, they're like, hey, there's the problem, let's fix it. Not, there's the problem, let's make money off the treatment. You know, we can cure cancer, but I'd rather make money off you first. That's embarrassing, bro. Imagine if we knew half the shit that goes on, dude. And it brings up a good point too, because we're born in this time period, right? So we're born before shit gets really interesting, but we're born after, like, the really, really crappy stuff. You know, like, no houses, really, electricity, no cell. Imagine living with no cell phone or Google, or imagine none of this. Life would fucking suck. You want to talk about old grumpy cunts? Dude.
I know, it makes you think, like, in 100 years, like, what they're going to say. Like, oh, yeah, can you imagine being in 2020 and they didn't have
masks, man. You know what I mean, dude? Like, they're probably like, they're not going to talk like that, but I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, that's what they thought. Like, they didn't have hover cars back then? What?
Well, if you get rid of the people of Earth, who's going to clean the toilets? You know what I mean? It's like the alien version of The View. Well, if you get rid of the people of Earth, what are you going to do? Who's going to clean the toilet? And everybody's like, boo! Yeah, fuck no, dude. But yeah, we're born in, like, a weird time period where, like, what? Have you, like, I don't think people really think about this because we're too busy being, like, obsessed with celebrities and, you know, who makes the most money. And I work 80 hours this week, you know, like, I've worked 100. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, not cool for that. But imagine, have anybody ever just sat down and said, what's the chances that I'm born in this time period? You even had a point. And like, if everything got wiped away, like the internet, and there was no way for us to access it, how do we know what time it is? I mean, yeah, we would know what time it is, but, like, if all the information we had just ceased to exist and we didn't know where it went, we can literally make up our own rules. Like, it's literally just, like, we're here and we're just making shit up. It basically seems like that. We're just making shit up because we don't know a lot about anything. So we just make shit up. How do I know it's 10 o'clock somewhere else in the universe? I don't. We just made that up. Like, it kind of seems like that's what life is, really. Like, we're just born in this time period. And I'm just like, it feels like I'm in a play right now. Like, before I was born, it's like, hey, this is your script. This is what's going to happen. Action. Because it kind of just seems like fake. When I go to work and I'm, like, helping people, I'm like, bro, what am I doing here? I could be at home. I could be having fun and exploring. But instead, I'm born in the year, I'm in the 2000s, and I'm wearing a fucking mask for 9 hours a day, and I have to, like, pretend to want to help you. Now I have to pretend like I'm interested in helping you at work. Hey, you know, like, fun chaja. Now I have to pretend, like, I know, like, I want to help you. Now I have to be like, oh, yeah, I can help you with that, man. You know what I mean? Yeah. Yeah, like, that's how they want you to act. Because if you don't act like that, you know, like, oh, he's kind of a problem. Anyways, born in the time period, it's weird to think about. I don't know why I was born in this time period, but you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to keep doing shit like this. We're going to keep having fun, and we're going to keep doing whatever the fuck we want. That's what I want to do. I don't want to do what everybody else wants me to do. Nope. I just want to have fun. And that's what we're doing here on this podcast. That was Meme of the Week. This is episode 56 of the DrewCast. If you guys are new here, we are on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, we're on YouTube, I'm on TikTok, Instagram. I'm gangbanging the whole fucking social media thing going on right now, dude. My dick's in every hole. If you got a hole, my dick's in it. With consent, of course, because we can believe in consent on this podcast. Not like when LeBron was trying to teach Pepe Le Pew about consent, because, you know what I mean? You don't got to teach a a skunk about that, but I don't even know what he is technically. I don't give a fuck. He's a cartoon. But until next time, guys, peace.